goody! It's that time. I get to get out of that crazy trunk and I get to see all the people. Yes, Jessie, we're glad to get to be here today. And here we are on, it is what, November the 17th. Oh, and it means it's Sunday afternoon and it's Bible story time with Chesley. C-H-E-S-L-E-Y. Yes, that's Chesley and not Chelsea. I know, not Chelsea. Why do people call me Chelsea? I don't know, Chesley. I think the name Chesley is not that familiar, and so they call you Chelsea. Well, it's not right. It's Chesley. So let's tell them again. Well, you already told them. I think we've emphasized that. Now, let's just tell our Bible story today. And let's sing, I love you and God loves you, and that's the way it should be. I love you and God loves you, and that's the way it should be. That's right. God loves you. We love God. He loves us. He loves everybody because he is, you know, he is like a wonderful fruit where there's all kinds, just a whole bunch of different kinds of fruits, like the fruits of the Spirit, the fruits of the Spirit. Where is those found? In Galatians 5 and 22 and 23. That's right. Do you know what they are? Love, joy, peace, and mercy, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. You got to be kind and all those kind of things. And that's just good. What if that was like a fruit? You know, we have a fruit salad sometimes, different fruits. And you know, they're sweet and they're good. And everyone likes them. That's right. Everyone likes them. So let's just consider it today. Chesley, let's think about us, in a way, being spiritual farmers. How's that going to happen? Well, you know, in our, let's just consider our heart, the one that beats blood in it. No, not this physical heart that beats, has blood flowing through it. But Chesley, we're thinking about that part of us that loves the Lord, serves Him. You know, that's the part where, let's just consider it's like a garden spot. And you're going to weed out all the junk? Yeah, you got to weed out. There could be awful weeds and you want to get those out. And how do you keep them getting out the, you know, the good fruit? That's the thing you have to be careful when you're digging around a plant is that you might, if you're trying to get the weed out, it comes a good thing. Oh, up, that's right. You can root out the whole plant. But we're going to talk about that, but we're going to tell a story in the Bible that goes along with that. And I'm going to sing the train song. You've already done your train song. Well, I think it should be done. Why should it be done? Because it's not theme song. It's all right. And the engineer. Oh, that's right. You are the engineer of the gospel train. Chesley's gospel train. All right. Chesley's gospel train. So you can sing that song, I guess. And you know, remember you said the Bible is like, it's got 66 books and this is like 66 cars. Like 68. That's right. Each book of the Bible is going to represent a train car. All right, this gospel train is chugging at the track, chugging at the track, it's chugging at the track. This gospel train is chugging at the track, chugging to the glory land. Get on board this gospel train, get on board this gospel train, get on board this gospel train. Yes, you can, yes, you can. Gonna see Jesus, yes, I am, yes, I am, yes, I am. Gonna see Jesus, yes, I am, yes, I am, yes, I am. Because this gospel train is chugging at the track, chugging at the track, it's chugging at the track. This gospel train is chugging at the track, chugging to the glory land. All right, that's a good song, Chesley, and I'm glad you wanted to sing that. Entered it on the engineer. Oh, yes, you're the engineer of the train. Okay, I have that. Chesley, there is a story in the book of Acts, chapter 10. And is it going to be a fruit patch? No, we're not going to talk about a fruit patch. But in a sense, we are. There was this man, and he was known as what we would call a Gentile. What's it one of them? Well, you know, there was the Jews, and that meant that they were actually in the family of Abraham's family. You know, ancestry thing. Oh, it's an ancestry thing. That's right. We hear a lot about that. And they could all say, well, I am from Abraham's family. And they thought they were special. Well, they were God's chosen people, and they really liked to talk about that. They call what we'd say without that. They were really somebody come. And what if you wasn't one of them? Well, if it was somebody that wasn't of the family of Abraham, well, they called them Gentiles, and they didn't really have any use for them. And so I don't think they had one of them fruits of the Spirit. Well, the fruits of the Spirit, like love, and certainly didn't have joy when they saw them, and they didn't have peace when they saw them. They didn't want to be around them. And they weren't gentle. I don't know. They weren't gentle. They wouldn't even walk through the land of these people that lived in Samaria. They wouldn't even walk through there because it was in Gentile. That's right. They didn't want anything to do with them. I think then is really then what did that Jesus? Well, Jesus loved everybody. I mean, he had fruits of the Spirit. Oh, I'm telling you, the fruits of the Spirit. He was sweet and gentle and kind and good and faithful. All these fruits of the Spirit, it was just good. That's what he had. And not, you know, they was being kind of mean. Yes, they were being mean and hateful. They would ignore those people. Well, there was this centurion. His name was Cornelius. Cornelius, did they call him Corny Cornball? No, I don't think they called him Corny Cornball. I don't think that would sound very nice. It wouldn't sound to me like you really was being sweet, like a good fruit. What if I was just teasing? Why don't we just not tease about that today? We're talking about being good and kind. Would you want somebody making fun of you and calling you Corny Cornball? Well, it's just a joke. I wouldn't care. Well, we're not talking about a joke today. Let's talk about this time when this man, he didn't know about Jesus. You know, he was a Gentile. And so I thought he was a centurion. I thought he was a big soldier. He was. He had 100 people that he was in charge of. But though he knew that there was a God, see, the Jews, they wouldn't tell him all about God. And he certainly didn't know a thing about Jesus. Oh, and they didn't like to set him free and save him from his sins. Yes, Jesus could save him from his sins. He could give you peace and joy, you know, all those fruits of the Spirit. He could have those fruits of the Spirit, but he needed somebody to tell him about Jesus. He needed to know that Jesus was the Son of God, and that he loved the Gentiles too. He needed to know that. Well, here's what happened. As this man was praying, he was so sincere. He was just calling out to the Lord, and he was doing the best he could. And what else did he do? Well, the Bible said he gave offerings. He just did everything he could. But he didn't know this God. But he knew that he just knew that there was a God that was the greatest one. He knew that there was a one true God. And so God heard him, and he had a plan. God has a plan when he sees somebody reaching out to him. And he said, you know what? He said, I want you to send some of your people, you know, some of his soldiers and some of his family. And yes, he's going to send what we would call just a group of people or a party of people. Oh, they're going to party? Oh, well, we're not talking about a party like a happy party. We're talking about going and just sending somebody to go and bring somebody that God was telling him. And he said to him, what did he say to him? Well, what he said to him, he said, I tell you what, said, I want you to send somebody to Joppa. Where is it? Joplin, Missouri? No, not Joplin, but it was Joppa. It was a city about 35 miles away. And he said, you send somebody there to see this man named Simon Peter. And Simon Peter, and who is he? Well, you know what? He's one of the disciples, so he knows truth. He's heard truth. And he said, you go there and said, I'll tell you where he is. He told him his address. He said, he's at Simon the Tanner's house. And so he knew exactly who he was, where he was. And it was a little town. I don't know if it was a little town or not. But everybody, if you said, I want to go to see the Simon the Tanner, everybody knew where Simon the Tanner was. Did he tan hides? Ooh, he's kind of scary. Oh, Chessie, we're not talking about tanning hides right now. So he said, okay, I know where to go. So he got a group of people, said, he is going to tell you. That's what, so the Lord spoke to him and said, he is going to tell you. Give you the answer to what you have, your question here today. Oh, so he hurried it, and how long did it take him to go? Well, it was from 35 miles, from what I read, it's going to take him a long time. So he got the people together and sent them, and so Peter was going to be the one. Oh, so and Peter is okay with doing it? Well, let's just find out about Peter. Well, the next day, and these fellas, remember, they're on the way to Joppa, and Peter, he had gone up, he was tired, and he had gone up, they had flat roofs, and they'd go up and take a nap. Oh, it's kind of siesta time? That's right, it was kind of siesta time. He went up there, and he was just going to take his nap. He was stretched out up there, and all of a sudden, he had what was called a vision. What's one of them things? Well, Chesley, it's like, I don't know, it's not a dream. It's above a dream. It's the Lord was speaking to him and actually showed him in what we call a vision. It was bigger, greater than a dream. It was actually from the Lord. And he saw this big old sheet come down in cold. Well, I don't know that it was cold, but what he saw, it had all kinds of animals in it. Animals? What do you mean? That's crazy. Oh, he was having a nightmare. No, he wasn't having a nightmare, but the Lord was showing him something. What's this got to do with the centurion? Well, you're fixing to find out what it had to do with it. He saw it and it had what we call clean and unclean animals. Oh, what do you mean? Some had a dance and some didn't? That really wasn't the way it was. See, there was a Jewish law, and there were certain animals that were considered good to eat and some that weren't good. Some tasted yucky. It wasn't about that. It was, Chesley, we're not going into the law, but there was a Jewish law, which animals was good to eat and some that weren't. They were not supposed to eat those. So when he saw this come down, and there was all these animals, he thought, he said, the zoo, couldn't he going to start a zoo? Well, no, the Lord didn't want to start a zoo. But here's what the Lord shocked him when he said, Peter, rise up, kill, and eat. Oh, what did Peter say? I thought you said something wasn't clean. Well, some of them were against the law. And he said, I can't break the law. I have never done that. Why, he said, I've never eaten those unclean animals. I follow the law. Yeah, that's right. So now what? I don't think he hurts and God hurts in the devil. It wasn't the devil. It was actually a vision, was for it with a purpose. The Lord was showing him, said, the time has come, so you need to know. He said that I want everybody to know this truth. You need to know that you've missed it in some area. You need to know that I love everybody. And he had love and joy and kindness and peace and long-suffering and gentleness and goodness. And he loved it all. And his love was just full. He had love. It was so full and so big that it included everybody. All, it didn't matter if you was a Jew or a Gentile. Oh, now, and what's he going to do? Is he all excited and happy? I don't know that he was so excited and happy. He didn't know what to think. But I know what he did find out. Yeah, what did they say? Down his garden? The garden in his heart. He found out he had a weed in there. Several weeds. Was it a hate weed? I don't know if it was like a hate weed, but it could. It was a, really, there was no kindness toward the Gentiles. Oh, he had to get that out because it wasn't like Jesus. That's right. If it wasn't like Jesus, if Jesus had kindness toward these people, and if he had peace and long-suffering, and he was reaching out to them, love them like this, he knew that he didn't have that. He had probably, I think he had hatred. He very likely did. He didn't want to be around them. And he thought, this is a weed in the garden of my heart. I've got to get rid of this. Oh, this is no good. How did he do it? Because he prayed. That's how we take care of these things in our life that shouldn't be there in our garden. And as he called out, and he knew this was wrong what I've done. In fact, this vision came to him three times. Three times. Why did he do that? Because he was hard-headed. He wasn't hard-headed. It was just the Lord was emphasizing, this is serious. I mean business. This is no joke. This is not just a little dream you're having. And what did he do then? Well, about that time, there was a knock on the door down there. Oh, they're at Simon the Tanner's house. And they said, oh, we have come here to see Simon Peter. Oh, you know what? The Lord spoke to his heart, and he said, you go with him, and don't you doubt one thing. Oh, and he got down there. I think his head was spinning. He didn't know what to think. He said, my head is spinning. I think it was. His head was probably likely just about to spin around about like that. He didn't know. He had never had anything happen like this. And what would people think? I mean, what would the other Jews think? And what would the priest? I mean, this was just awful. What is going to happen?
He knew it was true, and so he didn't run from it?
He did not run from it. And when those people came down, when he came down and they spoke together, and they poured the whole story out.
Corny corn dog.
About Cornelius.
Cornelius. I like corny corn dog better.
Well, let's call him Cornelius. He was a centurion. We do not want to disrespect him.
Because it would not be kind. I got to the fruit of the Spirit.
The fruit of the Spirit, yes, and we need to be good and kind. So he's told, he listened as they told him. He said, okay, I'll tell you what, I'm going to go with you.
And he was going to go, and the Lord said, don't you doubt one thing.
He said, he did, I'm not doubting one thing. And he, I tell you, as he
finally made the trip. What was it like going on that trip? I think going on that trip, he was thinking, the Lord has just been plowing it up in my heart. All these old weeds I had, they're gone. And you know, you're going to let the Lord do it. We've got to let the Lord do that. Just plow up anything in our life that doesn't belong there. We just say, yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way. Oh, as Peter preached the truth of them about Jesus being the Son of God, he could be their Savior too. You know, and what hit them. Oh my, after that long trip of walking down there, it was a long ways, but it was rejoicing to see, he rejoiced to see all those people were so happy. Did he get in your rest? You know, when he got there, he was probably tired, but I'm telling you, Cornelius was ready to hear the truth. He had an open heart in his family home. Oh, and they accepted Jesus as their Savior. What a wonderful time. And it was all because that Peter was willing to let Jesus get in the garden of his heart and do some plowing. He did some plowing in there. He went in there because he prayed and he said, yes, Lord, yes. And the Lord said, all right. He could take all any bitterness he had or unkindness he had toward the Gentiles. Oh, Chesley, what does this tell us? And he got us there, done, and we should too. We should too. Jesus loves the little children of the world. He loves everybody, adults and all. It doesn't matter what race we are. He loves us all. And he loves us to get rest, like go to bed and take naps. Oh, I knew you was getting into something. I don't want to go, Chesley. It's time for you to go to bed. Tell everybody goodbye. I don't think it's so good to get stuffed in the trunk. Chesley, you know the deal is you're going to bed. We'll see you next time, next Sunday afternoon. And goodbye, and I love you very much, and I hate this trunk. Chesley, you're doing well. The trunk is a very good place for you. We'll see you next week.